each case has got its own sort of set of dynamics and so forth. If you are dealing with something like 4 or 5 cases at a time, you are bound to discover that either on case number 3, you're making much more progress easily.
And so it is purely coincidental.
It's purely coincidental.
It's got nothing to do with any hidden agenda.
No, it has nothing to do with any hidden agenda. And I'm quite well aware that what people sought to do, and which I also found very baffling even at a legal level, to find even allegations by well-educated people called lawyers who would want to equate a matter that had been properly somewhat processed and arrived at in terms of recommendations and so forth, and then say, oh yeah, no, we are taking this kind of action to activate suspensions and so forth because of the Nkandla matter. And I was, you know, so it's a very baffling kind of equation in a sense, because the two have got absolutely nothing to do with each other and so forth.
Those critical of what you are doing point out, for example, that we didn't see the same attitude towards the police that were involved in Marikana, for example. Much as there's a commission of inquiry that is looking into that, but there are people who feel that certain steps could have been taken which would have shown South Africans that police do actually take, you know, those lives seriously or just as seriously.
Look, that's a different set of a case altogether, in a sense. Particularly in a sense that you remember that the president announced the setting up of a commission.
Almost immediately, yes.
Yeah. You know,
but I think, Minister, that perhaps even at a symbolic level, precautionary suspensions, you know, could have sent a signal that the government does care about those lives that were lost, even though that wouldn't necessarily be suggesting that those police that were involved there, or the people who issued the commands, were guilty.
But two things. I mean, if you were to arrive at such a position, we should also be careful that, you know, we shouldn't necessarily have the head of state having announced the setting up of a commission to look into those facts around the Marikana issue. We couldn't then be found to be undermining that particular position taken at that level, because essentially that's what it would mean. It would also mean undermining even the work of the commission itself.
Having looked at all these things that are happening, General Dramat, you know, Tlemeza, Mdluli, and so on. What do you think they are doing to people's confidence in the criminal justice system and in the police in particular?
The Hawks continue to do and register significant sort of milestones in the work that they're doing on a day-to-day basis. You have a set of committed men and women there who on a daily basis are doing their utmost best in around fighting organized crime and other areas of priority crime. So they continue to do that. You know, maybe post this engagement between the two of us, we can also forward you with recent statistics in terms of, you know, how.
No, I don't think there are doubts about the fact that work is being done. But what people in that space say, pundits, but also some of your own, senior officials within the police, what they are saying is that all this stuff that is going on at the higher levels is actually affecting the morale of the police on the ground. In situations where, for example, over the years, we had made a significant dent in, you know, reducing crimes, certain categories of crime, reducing murders, and so on. Now, again, they are spiking. And that's not because they don't have the resources. That's not because they don't have the expertise to deal with those issues. But it is because of all these other things, you know, where all these big guns are fighting up there. And then it cascades down by way of, you know, killing the morale of the police, who are then now increasingly becoming, you know, it's becoming difficult for them to do what they are supposed to do, and that is policing.
No, I think also those are matters of perception largely. Firstly, as you're referring to big guns fighting, I mean, there's no fighting. There's absolutely no fighting. The question is, you have things before you that have got to be processed. Okay, and the law is quite clear in terms of how these matters must then be processed and so on. Unless we are being asked that matters of a serious nature such as these brought before us, we should turn the other way and not, you know, consider them or not even have a look at them and so forth. And I think that will be an irresponsible kind of act on our side. It does concern me indeed that we have, in certain cases, perpetual kind of allegations that don't come to an end. And it's for this reason that, you know, even post this kind of work that we have already started, we'll also begin to look into some of these things. How do we make sure that we effectively deal with the aspect of negative image on the police,